News on the go.
A man is now facing charges, including murder, after a 12-year-old boy was shot and killed in Syracuse last month. The Onondaga County District Attorney's Office says Johanan Pizarro has been arrested and will be arraigned in a Syracuse City court this morning. 12-year-old James Springer III was shot and killed on John Street. Police say they do not believe, though, he was the intended target. Well, this all coming as Chief Frank Fowler prepares for his final day on the force. The 29-year veteran will hang up his hat and his badge at the end of today. His replacement, Little Rock, Arkansas Chief Kenton Buckner, will be sworn in on Monday. Of course, you can watch Christy Casciano's final interview with Chief Fowler on localsyr.com. Some breaking news overnight from Ontario County. Two people are dead after a huge house fire in South Bristol. Several departments were called to the home near Bristol Mountain around 8:30 last night after neighbors heard explosions. The sheriff says two bodies have been taken to the medical examiner's office to be identified. Well, Syracuse police are investigating an overnight crash on Lexington Avenue near Westcott Street. The two cars crashed around 2:15. We're told one person was taken to the hospital, but we don't know the extent of their injuries. We have reached out to police for more information this morning. Anthony Saccone is on his way to a long-term state prison. We don't know exactly where he'll end up, but the convicted drunk driver has been moved to the Elmira Correctional Facility. It's a spot where new inmates are housed until they can be moved to a permanent facility. That transition may last between 2 to 4 weeks.